friends from Eastern Pyrenees, France. It's Angelina and Dima here from Okinawa World. It's the start of September now, and we're about to begin our new hike, Dorres de Pays Tour de Cerdagne. This is one of the local circular trails, around 70 kilometers long, that is great to discover French Cerdagne Valley.
We decided to do this hike in honor of this beautiful sunny region, where we initially fell in love with mountains, and since then been living here for the last 3 years now. This trail is going to pass by many historical old villages and small churches, and of course we'll be surrounded by the beautiful natural environment with great mountain ranges, forests, fields and rivers. And we think it will take us around 4 to 5 days to complete this trail, as we plan on doing 15 to 17 kilometers a day, and hopefully the weather will allow us to enjoy it thoroughly, but we'll see that as we go. So let's get into it!
So today we start from the village Font-Romeu and we're planning to get to the small village Dorres. So in total it will be 15 kilometers for the day.
And we expect the difficulty of the trail to be moderate, with just a little bit of elevation gain. We think like maybe 500 meters or so. So this is the plan.
In this area there are a lot of bushes of wild red currant that grow all around the forest.
So we're starting our trail, as we said, in Font-Romeu, and are going to follow along the kind of northwestern part of the Cerdagne Valley, and we're heading towards southeastern part. So we know that some people advise doing it like clockwise, and we're going kind of counter-clockwise direction, but we honestly feel like it doesn't matter, like you can start whichever way you like. So yeah, now we're going to cross the highest part of this trail, we think, following along the massif, the Pic de Carlit, which we already know quite well, and we've traveled a lot there. We did many hikes there as well, climbing to the peaks and going around the lakes, which you can find, by the way, going to our Pyrenees playlist, where we stayed all of our videos, and you can discover those. So here you can see the sign that we're going to follow the next 4 or 5 days. This is the red-yellow sign, which means the GR of the country, so it's kind of a local trail, but not as long as the crossing of Pyrenees, for example, which is GR 11 or GR 10. And that sign is different, it's white and red, and this one is yellow and red. So gonna follow this.
The weather today is very nice, it's very warm, there is no single cloud in the sky, so it definitely feels like summer.
And just a week ago here, we already had several cold days. It was very rainy and cloudy, and we even had the snow on the top of the mountains, can you believe it, in the end of August. We think in 3 years that we've been living here, we have never seen it before, so it was very unexpected and unusual. And we were already afraid that we won't be able to continue hiking this season. But now the snow is gone, and fortunately we're able to continue.
For now, most of the trail has been going in the shadow, which is very nice because we're already in the middle of the day and it's quite hot in the sun.
This is apparently a really great weather for the paragliders to fly today, as we can see a lot of parachutes in the sky. And we just said it in the other video of ours, but this activity amazes us a lot and we would love to learn it. And there's actually a paraglide school here located right in this region in one of these villages, and this is just perfect, we think. We're now following the gentle downhill, passing by the village Targasson and heading to the Angus stream, which is very close to our final destination. So it is the middle point of our hike for today. Under our feet we already can see a lot of yellow and dry leaves, and it means that the autumn is around the corner, and we honestly feel that this summer passed by so quickly. We don't know about you guys, we didn't feel like it was enough summer. No, we didn't do enough hiking probably, that's the reason one. And overall it's just very weird feeling, and let us know how it is for you guys if you can relate. Yeah, compared to our last year when we spent 4 full months living in a tent, we actually have a video out about that, so make sure to watch it if you haven't yet, where we share all of our impressions and stuff. This summer is such a drastic difference, and yeah, we can feel this one, but still we can do some more hiking in, and the weather is nice, so happy for that. Arrived at the Temesvar station by the same trail that we took exactly 3 years ago when we just first started hiking in the mountains, and it was actually the first hike that we filmed, so we'll leave the link here on the screen. This is like very funny to look back at it now. We're kind of very inexperienced, not to say that we're experienced now, but 3 years ago we were just starting out from scratch, and yeah, so it brings up a lot of unforgettable memories. And overall, doing this trail to the Cerdagne would be very special to our hearts because we've done a little bits of every trail of every day, different points of time, but we have never done the full circle of it, so yeah, it's gonna be a very memorable one. And this solar station behind me is actually one of the oldest ones that was built back in 1980s, and now it is not working, but there is a new one, actually more than one station, which we hopefully gonna pass by, but it's gonna be one of our final days on this trail. And overall, this region is very famous for a lot of sunny days in all the seasons around the year. And that's why there are a lot of solar infrastructure here, like solar furnace and several solar stations here. So yeah, we think that it's very interesting. Done the highest uphill for the day and descending down to the village Angustrin, which is going to be our major downhill for the day, and our final destination is there. You can see it. Finally, it seems like this long, steep downhill of around 4 kilometers long, I think, is coming to an end. We're coming down to the Angustrin village and off we go to Dorres. This by far was the most challenging part of our trail for today.
So we are indoors now. Our day is coming to an end. It was a very hot day. The trail was okay, but the downhill was quite challenging.
Yeah, today we passed by many beautiful villages, rocky buildings, churches. Now we're actually in a very nice place, Dorres, which is a very, very small village that has the Roman baths in it that we didn't pass, but just so we know it is here. And yeah, we're very grateful for the weather. It feels like summer, and now it's like very nice, nice evening, very warm. And wish it would never end. So yeah, we can say that it was a successful day. Yeah, we're very excited for the next one. We're quite tired now, we want to sleep. Probably gonna have a little bit of shower now because it is not cold and should be fine. So yeah, gonna find our camp spot for tonight and we'll show you that in a minute.
Thanks a lot for watching. Hope you enjoyed this hiking trip. If so, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more hiking adventures. Don't forget to hit the bell to stay notified about every new video. Visit our website walkingnatureworld.com to find detailed hike reports with pictures and maps. Hope you have a wonderful day and we'll see you very soon.